Table 8 qualifying is a crucial trial for tank crews that will evaluate their ability to put steel on target. The phrase steel on target is used to describe a tank team's ability to engage moving and stationary targets with a variety of weapons during daylight and periods of limited visibility. All offensive tasks will require the tank to fire on the move at speeds reaching and exceeding 25 miles per hour. The crews know that Table 8 qualifying is a serious test of their skills. The targets they will be shooting at will be viewed by them as actual enemies. In a real battle, the quickness with which a crew can utilize its machine gun and main gun batteries will determine whether they live or die. Table 8 will ensure that in all cases, it is the enemy that will be struck down and destroyed. The interior of the M1 turret gives an impression of calm and spaciousness. But once on the move, the engines will thunder, and cordite fumes will combine with 100-degree heat, making the cabin anything but a pleasant environment. Tank Commander Charles Cherico and Gunnery Sergeant Jimmy James prepare for the grueling ordeal ahead of them. Today's Table 8 test will determine whether they are ready for the ultimate challenge of combat. As loader specialist Iran Days double checks his controls, driver Leon Gant is given the order by Tank Commander Cherico to move forward. As Table 8 begins, the excitement quickly reaches a fevered pitch as targets loom on the horizon, threatening the M1 and its crew with destruction. Things happen in the blink of an eye. Once a target is located and laser subsystems are activated, the job of killing a stationary or moving target belongs solely to the crew. Two targets exist in Table 8 qualifying, tank and infantry. Points are higher for tank kills, while infantry kills made by machine gun hits are somewhat lower. For the moment, Cherico and his crew concentrate solely on tank kills. The M1 uses the Sabo shell, a devastating dart-shaped projectile that streaks through the air in a corkscrew trajectory. It can penetrate the thickest armor in the world and then blow apart inside an enemy tank. Its killing effectiveness against armor and crews is gruesomely efficient. Cherico knows that his Sabo kills are good, but that a new threat confronts his crew. Machine gun batteries must be manned and manned quickly as enemy targets appear less than 100 yards away. Cherico and crew nail solid kills, but enemy targets are everywhere. Sergeant Cherico and his crew have so far blasted every target off the desert, but the Table 8 tasks come hard and fast. Gunner James angles his gun into position, ready for Cherico's command to again fire on enemy positions, sometimes referred to as most dangerous targets, or BMPs. Ratings for Cherico and his crew are based on a point system, 1,000 total points representing main cannon and machine gun fire, both in defensive and offensive tasks, is a perfect score. Sergeant Cherico and his crew need a minimum of 700 points to qualify. Should they fail to achieve this minimum, they will repeat the Table 8 task where poor scoring was indicated until qualification is issued. Cherico continues to give the order to fire, and Gunner James responds with identify and on the way.
On the way!
On the way means another kill, and Cherico gives thumbs up to his men. If Table 8 right now was a real battlefield, then it would be a pretty bloody place indeed for the enemy. So far, Sergeant Cherico's crew has crippled enemy opposition. Table 8 is drawing to a close, and Chirico's crew is looking forward to obtaining the minimum number of points needed for qualification. Sergeant Chirico, however, will push his tank and crew to shoot for a perfect score. Other tanks are also struggling to qualify in the vastness of this live fire training range. A tank downrange of Sergeant Chirico's M1 engages infantry targets. In case of close infantry attack, the crew must coordinate machine gun fire together. The gunner fires the main cannon and a 7.62 caliber coaxial machine gun. The loader shoots another 7.62 caliber machine gun at his station, while the tank commander operates a 50 caliber machine gun from his command position. The crackle of machine gun fire is deafening as rounds slice through the air in search of targets. The machine gun scores are not good, and this means that the task must be completed again. Another Table 8 run will have to be repeated by this tank crew until the main gun and machine gun batteries work together in perfect harmony. Meanwhile, Sergeant Chirico and his crew continue to stalk enemy targets. The main cannon leads the M1 forward like an enormous antenna, eager to find and strike a dangerous enemy target. Sabo shells are loaded, and Chirico acquires his targets as fast as possible. Unlike a Hollywood Western where the good guys have unlimited rounds for their guns, Chirico's crew has only a limited supply of rounds within which to complete each task. If they run out of rounds before the next task comes up, they lose crucial points needed for qualification. For 5 days and nights, Sergeant Chirico and his determined crew have ravaged enemy targets. They have already surpassed the minimum requirement of points for qualification, but these tankers will be satisfied with nothing less than a perfect score. Identify, fire, and on the way are words that echo through the M1. The will to be the best and emerge victorious is the greatest weapon Chirico and his crew possess. As targets are decimated one after another, it becomes clear to the judges and Sergeant Chirico that his tank and crew are red-hot winners. The next assignment they receive will be one that could take them into the real fury of battle. Sergeant Chirico and his crew will be ready, willing, and able to meet the challenge.